Good morning, McAvenue School. Mr. Domina here, handling the McAvenue morning announcements. Today is Monday, January 30th, 2023. Thank you once again for joining me for the Monday edition of McAvenue's morning announcements. What a way to launch our week with another edition of morning announcements. We have lots to cover, everyone, including a reminder for tomorrow. So tomorrow on Tuesday at 9:30 to 10:15 a.m. in the gymnasium, it's another edition of McAvenue's Lions Pride Core Value Celebration, January edition. That's where we recognize students that have been respectful, responsible, and safe in every classroom. And then we talk about attendance and see how you did overall as a school and see which class in each grade level had the highest percentage of attendance for the month of January. We do have a very special surprise that we will be revealing for the first time near the end of this edition of Lions Pride. So you don't want to miss out. Come to school, be on time. It's going to be another amazing time in the gym celebrating all the hard work that you have done for the month of January. That is it for your reminder. So let's start like we always do, coming together as one unified collective school by reciting the Pledge of Allegiance. Best way to come together, all right? So let's stand up, turn your voice off, put your right hand over your heart, make sure to face the flag that's in your classroom or learning space, and we will begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Nice job, everyone. I cannot think of a better way to launch our day, showing the ultimate sign of respect as one unified collective school. Always makes me feel good when we do that. All right, take a look at that picture. Brand new yoga pose of the week. It's called the geyser. And since it is a yellow pose, if you see the back of the card, it is yellow. That means that it involves some traditional yoga movements as well as using your imagination, right? Imagination is when you really think about something and kind of take yourself out of the moment and really visualize you in a different spot or visualize something completely different to kind of get your body and mind in the right state for the yoga pose. In this particular case, the geyser pose releases any tension and negativity that we might be feeling inside or any extra energy by releasing it like a geyser. And you might be wondering, what is a geyser? We'll take a look at that picture, right? That's in Yellowstone National Park, one of the most famous national parks, and I believe it is the largest national park in the United States, and that is a geyser. So a geyser basically is like a small mountain or hill, not very big at all. And if you notice, there is what looks like water and steam that's coming out of it. And that is actually what happens. So similar to a volcano, where underneath the ground where you don't see, there's pressure that's built up through a variety of different things, right? Remember, underneath, we have those tectonic plates that are moving back and forth, right? We have lava, a bunch of different things that are happening under the ground and surface, and that builds up pressure sometimes, and the pressure needs to be released. And in this case, lava doesn't come out like a volcano. It's actually steam and water that comes out, right? And usually it is warm or in some cases really hot. So the geyser, when you go to a national park like Yellowstone, you can't get right near it because it's not actually safe to do so, right? So that's what I want you to think about with the geyser pose. You want to release all of that extra negative energy, any extra energy that you have, any tension, just like that geyser picture that we showed. So let's get to it. So we're going to start in the standing mountain pose, which are the feet hip width apart and our hands down by our side. Movement number one, put your hands right in the center of your chest, right by your heart. And movement number two really involves kind of exploding from this position with your arms out and your feet spread out. But you have to visualize first. So I want you to think about anything that you might be worrying about, any extra energy that you might be having, any negative thoughts, and I want you to storm right down in your belly, all right? Now, I want you to think about that geyser picture that I just showed you, right? I want you to have it build up, and then we're going to release it with that movement where we jump out with our arms out to our side and our feet out, but we also have to make a sound like a geyser releasing hot steam. That sound is, all right, can everybody do that? All right, awesome. Now let's put it all together. All right, on the count of three, we're going to do the movement and the sound. One, two, three. All right, let's do it one more time. Hands right in the center together, right by your heart. On three, let's put the movement and sound together. One, two, three. All right, so that is the geyser pose. Very easy pose to do. I know that I had a little bit of negative energy that I was storing up right in my chest coming into work today. Very busy day at the Domina household. My dog not willing to want to go on the walk this morning caused me a little bit of extra tension because I felt like I was going to be late to come to McAvenue. So I needed to release that, and I was able to release it using the geyser pose. So we'll practice this again on Wednesday. It's going to be amazing. And it's just a really cool way to visualize and do a quick yoga technique. The geyser, one of my favorite poses, always helps me, and hopefully it helped you. So nice job, everyone. All right, it's birthday time. Another brand new birthday graphic. And remember, on the Monday edition of Morning Announcements, we cover the Sunday birthdays and the Monday birthdays. So on Sunday, January 29th, 2023, no birthdays at McAvenue, no student birthdays or faculty birthdays. And on Monday, January 30th, which is today, we have Clara's birthday in room 304 and Yadiel's birthday in room 308. So let's get our birthday celebration. Round of applause, hands ready to go, so we can launch these birthdays in full McAvenue style. Here we go. All right, stay tuned for the Wednesday edition where we will cover the Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday birthdays. So happy birthday, everyone that is on that list. All right, McAvenue's joke of the day. It is a Mr. Domina joke, not a student joke that's shared out. And let's get to it. No setup needed. So what do you get when you cross a snowman and a vampire? Think about that one, right? We're in the winter. A lot of that snow is already melting, but I want you to really think about that one, right? Build a snowman outside and you have that snowman standing there. What do you do when you cross that with a vampire? What do you think you get? Do you have your guess, prediction, or suggestion locked in your mind? I'm already laughing. It's a good one. You know what you get? That's right. You get frostbite. That's right. When you cross that snowman with a vampire, you get frostbite, all right? And take a look at that picture. There we go. Found a picture of a snowman that is actually a vampire crossed together and blended. So that's McAvenue's joke of the day. Remember to share it with family and friends to get them to smirk, to get them to smile, and better yet, to get them to laugh. That snowman has frostbite. All right, stay tuned for the Wednesday edition. Brand new joke. Could be your joke if you shared one with me. You never know. You're going to have to watch on Wednesday. All right, we do have some good news stories to share out. Take a look at that picture from the art room. Students in room 308 mastering the printmaking technique, which is really, really cool. Working hard as always in the art room. And Miss Epaul still never ceases to amaze me and you with all the great things that she does. So nice job, students in room 308. Ooh, we had a big field trip that took place at McAvenue, and it was the Museum of Science trip that happened on Friday. So our third grade students traveled all the way to Boston and enjoyed a day at the Museum of Science. Take a look at those pictures. That's only a few of what was shared. I heard they did an amazing job, and they really represented McAvenue well, and they actually did a lot of amazing learning. That place, if you haven't gone to the Museum of Science, is great. So they enjoyed it, and hopefully the teachers enjoyed it. It's really great to be able to leave campus and take the learning to a brand new spot. So nice job, grade three students. Great time at the Museum of Science. Pardon me. Take a look at that lady right there. She is Sovi in room 203, Lexia champion. She completed, believe it or not, take a look at this thing, 289 units on Lexia. Those are like lessons similar to ST Math. And she ended up getting that Lexia Superstar certificate. So congratulations, Sovi. Amazing job and a great, great picture. All right, shifting gears a little bit to ST Math. We have some 100 presenters that we need to talk about. First one is Corbin in room 101. He completed all the grade two puzzles and journey objectives. Bingo, he will be on the 100 percenters board in the main office. Congratulations, Corbin. We also have Madeline. She is in room 201, completed all the grade one puzzles and journey objectives. She will also be on McAvenue's 100 percenters board. And I notice students, when they're entering the office area, are checking out that 100 percenters board. It is growing and growing every single week. Simply, simply amazing. All right. So normally we would do a round of applause right now, but we're going to actually continue some more global school ST Math good news. We are at 557,574 puzzles cruising along. We will soon be at 600,000 puzzles, and that million puzzle challenge seems to be in reach by the end of the school year. That will be simply amazing if we're able to make it. So nice job, everyone. Here's our percent progress as a school. 56% progress already. That means 56% of the lessons at McAvenue are already completed. We are past the halfway point. I believe we are going to be at or above 100% progress as a school by the end of the school year. So here's the breakdown. Pre-K, 35%. Kindergarten, 42%. Grade 1, 62%. Room 109, 23%. Grade 2, 52%. Grade 3, 59%. Room 108 at 49%. And grade 4 at 62%. Tied for first place with grade 1. Nice job, everyone. I know that percent progress will only go up by the end of the week, but nice, nice work. And here we go. A little bit of share out that we're going to do with third and fourth grade. These are the top puzzlers last week. We had Eric in room 301, 88 puzzles completed. Lorenzo in room 108, 60 puzzles. In room 302, Viviana, 72 puzzles. In room 303, Nicholas with 74 puzzles. Room 304, Camilla with 84 puzzles. And moving on to grade 4, in room 307, we have Yalia at 64 puzzles. 108, Samaya at 98 puzzles. 308 is Sina at 66 puzzles. Room 309, Jalen at 66 puzzles. And room 310 is Katie at 60 puzzles. So nice, nice job. Now it is time to do our celebration, congratulations, round of applause for all the good news, stories that we're sharing. Well, that was a lot of them, all right? So nice job, everyone. I like the effort here at McAvenue. Let's keep it up and have more good news stories shared out. And there'll be more to come on the Wednesday edition. A little bit of ST math update. So this first one right here, I made the arrow in red, that winter waddle challenge where we take a picture of the tracker and share it with ST math. That is officially over as of the 27th. Of January, but we still have two more challenges. We have McAvenue's own challenge. It goes up to the 31st of January. That's a percent progress increase starting on the 9th all the way to the end of the month, and I will share out the results. We do have some movement, which is great, and we also have that national challenge here where we have to have 50 puzzles or more is the average overall. I didn't get the update yet, or I didn't look up the update yet, but I'll make sure to share that on the Wednesday edition. I know that we are probably over 50 puzzles as the average puzzles completed, but I didn't grab that graphic. I'll do it on Wednesday. All right, so let's go to that middle one right here, like we always do. And there's the breakdown, the top five classes after the three weeks that we've done McAvenue's ST Math Winter Waddles. Percentages are in the right. Penguin footprint and the homeroom, as usual, will be in the left. So we're going to focus on first place. And right now, room 201 has been in first place the whole time. Let's do our round of applause to see if they remain there. In first place, the 33.4% is, again, room 201. Nice job. And in second place at 27.4%, here we go, drum roll please. It is room 207. No movement on that, so nice job. No movement in the top two spots. It is getting closer though. You notice that gap is being closed in on room 201, so we could have some movement by the end of the week. In third place at 24.4%, drum roll please. All right, we have our friends in room 307. Nice job. And in fourth place, right behind them at 23.2%. Drum roll, please. Ooh, we have a tie. Our friends in room 309 and our friends in room 310, two fourth grade classes going to battle right there. They are tied for fourth place. And in fifth place at 22.4%. Drum roll, please. All right, here we go. Fifth place is room 208. Nice job. There is the updated percent progress top five classes at the end of the third week of ST Math's McAvenue's Winter Waddle. Amazing job. That deserves an extra round of applause. Here we go. All right. So stay tuned. There could be another update either on Wednesday or Friday. So stay tuned. Let's see if we can get some movement. The gap is really closing between third place and fourth place and first place and second place. So let's see what happens with the movement. Always exciting when we do these challenges. All right. Nice job, everyone. Hey, look at that. Look at that blank teal. Looks like a brick wall. When you see that, you know it's time to talk about McAvenue's core values. Oh, I like that graphic. What's the first one, everyone? That's right. It is respect. And that second one? Amazing. Nice job, responsibility. And that last one? Perfect. It is safety. So what I want everybody to focus on is respect. And respect in the stairway is what I want you to focus on. So one thing that we do when we're being respectful in the stairway is, I'm going to look back here on the matrix. It is that we stay to the right. So staying to the right is you find your right hand, put your right hand on the railing, and you will be on the right side. That's going up and down. That allows students to be able to go up on the right-hand side and other students to be able to go down on the right-hand side. When you do that, you are respectful. The other thing on the matrix is honoring bubble space. That means that you are giving room for the person that's in front of you and the person that's behind you so that we're not all crushed together when we're moving up and down the stairs. Got to respect that bubble space. And that third thing under respect is that voices turned off. Now, remember, this isn't a silent school, but we're on the stairway. Remember, it echoes, right? The high ceilings in the stairway, if you were on the bottom of the stairs being loud, that sound travels all the way up to the top and goes all the way out in the hallway. So just because you are moving around the building doesn't mean other kids are not in classroom learning, and we don't want to interrupt that, right? So voices technically should be off, but they need to be as quiet as possible. I will accept that, all right? Those are the three things I want you to work on in the stairway under respect. Give me a double thumbs up if you can do that respect challenge today. Boom, I like it. And remember, when we put respect, responsibility, and safety all together, that's right, we will continue to make McAvenue the best school that we all know. So that's it from me. Let's do our fist bump sign out. Let's get it up. Let's turn it. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. So go get them today. Work hard today. Laugh today. Smile today. Remember your respect core value challenge that I just reviewed. Work hard today on all of your work. It's assessment time, which means assessment, boys and girls, is a time where we provide you with a test so we can see what you know and really be able to shape the teaching to meet your needs. And try 100% on those. I believe we have ST Math that's launched this week for reading, so make sure you do your very, very best. 100%. I think it launches this week. It does. I believe it is. It's in that newsletter that I share with the teachers. But sometimes Mr. Domino, with all the things that are happening, can't remember. But I believe that's coming up this week. And outside of that, get your ST Math done. You never know what's going to happen on Friday with our top five, movement for percent progress from McAvenue's Winter Waddle Challenge. And I'll catch up with everybody in all the usual places, which is everywhere. Be on time for school tomorrow so you can make McAvenue's core value all school celebration January edition. All right, that's it. Long outro. So take care, and I will catch up with everybody soon. See ya.